Everyone and welcome. Let's take a look at the Burg Wächter Vulcan laminated padlock. This is a laminated padlock being produced by the German company Burg Wächter. The Vulcan, featuring a hardened shackle, should be 10 millimeters in diameter. This padlock is called the 111-50 version. I was not able to find it on the webpage. Interestingly, it features a quite restrictive keyway, and the reason why I'm taking this padlock apart is because Bosnian Bill tried to pick it on the airport. He said that the core does give him very little feedback. So I went to my new milling machine friend who has his CNC milling machines. We did this on the hand adjustable milling machine, not on the Herco Ultimax. But as you can see, really smooth work here on the rivet heads. Yeah, coming up next, we will take this padlock apart. We will gut it, and we will mainly gut the core. Take a look at the pins featuring the core and take a look at the quite restrictive keyway. Okay, see you in the next part of the video. Stay tuned. Okay, we've taken apart the Burg Wächter Vulcan padlock now. As you can see, I damaged it a little bit while clamping it up in the vise. Maybe next time I have to be a bit more careful there. First correction, the shackle diameter is 9 millimeters and not 10 millimeters. Here we have the core, the cover plate and the spring for the shackle, and here we got the pins, and let's take a look at the pins and evaluate why Bill had problems getting feedback there. Okay, first of all, what do we have here? We have all stainless steel springs, then we got three spooled driver pins, two normal driver pins, and then all normal key pins. Normally nothing special, but you may recognize that the driver pins are quite small and also the springs are quite small. Oh, here we got the sear clip for the core. Okay, let's take a look at the core. Someone on the UK Locksport forum, he mentioned that this could be the BUR13 keyway. I have to go with that, because I also think this could be the BUR13 keyway, but I'm not sure. As you can see, the inner housing is made out of brass and the outer housing is again a zinc die cast. And you may notice that this part here of the core where the driver pins are in is very short. If we compare that to the commander lock core, here the commander lock core of the Y52 keyway, and there we can see how short this is. But I do think that this is not the only reason why Bill did get so little feedback. I think the main reason would be the restrictiveness of this keyway here. Because if we take this core out and if we compare it to the Y52 core and now get ourselves a lock picking tool like this one here, which is already a very slim version, we may notice that for example, you stick your pick in and the pick can still move within the Y52 keyway. It can get a bit difficult on a few points, like here you can get stuck. This is why this keyway here is quite restrictive, but the blanks are still widely available. And let's take a look at the BUR13 keyway and how it is here. Here the keyway is really restrictive, and when you try to get a lock picking tool in here, you will notice it's quite hard to maneuver in there. And if we get our pick to the back, you may notice that now the lock picking tool is really quite stuck and you can't really move around. You maybe have to re-enter the pick at the bottom then in order to get it here to the bottom. and then you might reset a lot of pins. So I think this is the main reason why this padlock was so difficult to pick for Bill and why he hasn't picked it yet. I will give him another shot. I have another of these padlocks here, and I'm sure he will be able to crack it. But I think this is the main reason. It's probably the key way of this padlock. Okay, see you in the next part of the video. Does this quite restrictive keyway make this padlock a good padlock? No, not really. And I'm going to explain to you now why. First of all, let's take a look at the padlock. And as you may have noticed, I was not able to remove the shackle, nor the actuator. I'm going to explain to you now why. The actuator is still in place, and so are the ball bearings. Here we got the ball bearings. Also not really a good quality. Let's take a look at the actuator down there. And there you can already see the reason why I was not able to remove it. First of all, the actuator is produced out of a zinc die cast. Here we got the actuator. And here we got two notches, notch number one and notch number two, which are two notches that are part of one of the lamination layers, and they will hold the actuator in place. I can move the actuator and unlock the padlock or lock the padlock, but I cannot remove it because of these two notches that hold the actuator in place. Also, this is the 50 millimeter version with a thicker shackle than the commander lock, but still it weighs the same. And why is that so? Because they've done some things to save material, save weight. First of all, we got this window here. This window does not have to be there. This window here could be closed, but they got that window to save material, I believe. Also, we have this piece here. If we take our core and put the core in, you will notice that this part here, the spring is on this side, so here it's just empty space, maybe also to save material and save weight. Then we have this hole here, which is a mystery to me. It reaches all the way up to the first plate, and there is nothing inside. There is nothing inside. I checked it. I can reach all the way through to the first plate. There is nothing in there. Maybe this was a secret compartment for German spies to transport their microfilms into foreign countries. Okay, I'm getting a bit paranoid here. Just a wild guess. I have no idea what this is for. And yeah, as I said, I believe that the keyway restrictiveness is really cool, but all the rest of the padlock is not really good quality. Also, the core, I mean, even though you can normally not remove it, it doesn't have the holes or the key pins here up top. Okay, still, interesting padlock, interesting core, very interesting keyway restriction, but not a good choice. I wouldn't use it, I wouldn't buy it, because in my opinion, it's not really a good padlock. It's probably made in China, I believe. I don't think this is made in Germany, really not. Okay, I hope you enjoyed this video. Feel free to subscribe and have a nice evening. Bye-bye.